What's up guys, in this tutorial I will show you how to check your CPU's temperature on Windows 11. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. There are a lot of paid and free programs that can show your processor's temperature, such as Core Temp, MSI Afterburner, or simply through your BIOS. I would suggest installing MSI Afterburner to your PC, as it's lightweight, generally free of bloatware, and it gives you some other important metrics and custom settings. Click on the link in the description below, or navigate to msi.com, and from here, click on Download Afterburner. This will start the 50 MB download of the setup installer, and should only take a minute to complete. Your browser can help you find your downloaded files. After downloading the zip file, right-click the file and select Extract All. This will unpack the file into the same folder. Next, double-click the setup installer and follow the install wizard to install the application to your system. After the installation is done, you will notice a new shortcut created on your desktop. Double-click the shortcut, or simply search for Afterburner to open up the app. Here, you will be able to inspect your CPU's temperature and a lot of other useful information about your system. You can change the voltage, clock speed, and fan limits and speeds of your system. In your settings, you have the option to change your master graphics processor, enable or disable the active hardware monitoring graphs, and below, in your monitoring settings tab, enable the Show in Tray icon option. After applying your changes, you can preview your CPU's temperature in your system tray without having to open MSI Afterburner. You also have the option to change the color and change the text preview to a bar chart if you prefer this. Under User Interface, you have the option to change how Afterburner presents the information to you by changing the user interface properties, layout, and design. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.